Welcome back. In these videos, we review the rules of calculation for differentiation. In the previous video, we considered the product rule. The other very important rule of calculation is the chain rule. Consider a diver in the sea. To avoid decompression sickness, the rate at which the diver can return to the surface must be restricted. The issue is not so much the change in height, but the change in pressure. During the diver's ascent, the pressure is a function of the depth, x, which itself is a function of time. Thus, we are interested in the derivative of the pressure as a function of time. If we consider a short period of time, delta t, then the change in pressure equals the change in pressure per meter times the change in depth in this short time. Taking the limit as delta t goes to zero, we find that the change in pressure per second equals the derivative of the pressure as a function of depth times the derivative of the depth as a function of time. In the formula, this becomes f of g of x prime equals f prime of g of x times g prime of x. Notice that the derivative of pressure as a function of depth is typically almost constant, so the rules on the speed of ascent are typically given just in terms of speed. There are two frequent mistakes made when using the chain rule. The first one is to forget the factor g prime of x. The second one is that we need to evaluate the derivative of the outer function f at the value g of x and not at x. You can remember this using the diver. Where should we evaluate the derivative of the pressure as a function of depth? Well, obviously, at the depth we are currently at, which is given by the value of the inner function. As an example, we now calculate the derivative of ln of x squared plus 1. The derivative of the natural logarithm equals 1 over x. So we see for the derivative of ln x squared plus 1 that we obtain 1 over x evaluated at x squared plus 1 times the derivative of x squared plus 1, which is 1 over x squared plus 1 times 2x. Finally, the derivative of f over g is often given as an extra rule, the quotient rule. It's easiest to think of this as a combination of the chain rule and the product rule. Indeed, f over g equals the product of f of x and 1 over g of x. So using the product rule, we obtain that this equals f prime of x times 1 over g of x plus f of x times the derivative of 1 over g of x, which is f prime of x over g of x plus f of x. And to calculate the derivative of 1 over g of x, we use the chain rule. So we need to know the derivative of 1 over x, which is the derivative of x to the minus 1. So we get minus 1 times x to the minus 2, which is minus 1 over x squared. So we get minus 1 over gx squared times the derivative of g. Putting everything under the same denominator, we obtain f prime of x times g of x minus f of x times g prime of x divided by g of x squared. Remembering the quotient rule this way, make sure you never get the wrong sign in this rule again. For example, the derivative of x over x squared plus 1 equals 1, the derivative of x over x squared plus 1, plus plus x times the derivative of 1 over x squared plus 1, which is minus 1 over x squared plus 1 squared times the derivative of x squared plus 1, which becomes x squared plus 1 over x squared plus 1 squared plus x times minus 1 times derivative of x squared plus 1 is 2x over x squared plus 1 squared, which we can simplify to 1 plus x squared minus 2x squared is 1 minus x squared over x squared plus 1 squared. Now, have a look at the exercises.